A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 5th September. So on the front page you have India, Russia against outside influence in internal issues. So this is Prime Minister Narendra Modi who has clearly stated that both India and Russia are against outside influence in the internal matters of any nation. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi is in Russia, he is in Vladivostok. We had been discussing about it that he is going to visit Russia, and he has become the first Indian Prime Minister to visit Russian Far East region. So Russia is a huge nation, the Far Eastern region, Vladivostok has been visited by him. The two nations discussed various issues of bilateral cooperation like trade, defense, space, oil and gas, nuclear energy and maritime connectivity. Then here you have Azhar, Hafiz and Dawood designated as terrorists. So this is regarding the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act, which has been amended in 2019. So just a month after the act has been amended by the parliament, and the controversial provision of designating people as terrorists has been included, which the government said that will be used only for hardened criminals and terrorists. So the first step has been taken in that, and Jaish-e-Mohammed chief Masood Azhar, Lashkar-e-Taiba member Hafiz Saeed and his deputy Zakir Rahman Lakhvi have all three been designated as terrorists, along with underworld don Dawood Ibrahim, who planned and executed 1993 Mumbai serial blast. So these are the first four persons designated as terrorists under this act passed by parliament on August 2. So what will be the consequences of this designation is mentioned here. You can see it empowers National Investigation Agency NIA to seize property which previously required permission from Directorate General of Police. Now that property can directly be seized by NIA. And also it allows NIA officers of the rank of inspector or above to investigate cases. And now that is the case. Earlier it was only Deputy Superintendent or Assistant Commissioner of Police or above who could do so. Then below you have Kartarpur Pact stuck over fees. So the agreement on Kartarpur Corridor project, which will open the famed pilgrimage center in Kartarpur for Sikhs in Punjab, this center would be open to Indians. But this Kartarpur Corridor project pact could not be signed yesterday because Pakistan declared that it would charge fees from the visitors. So on this issue, the pact has been stuck now. Pakistan won't allow consular officials to accompany pilgrims also. Then here you have Hong Kong leader scraps extradition law. So Hong Kong chief executive has bowed down to a key demand of protesters following 3 months of unrest and has announced withdrawal of the extradition bill. However, activists have vowed to press on with their campaign because they have not just demanded scrapping of the bill, but also other demands like she herself should step down is also one major demand. Chinese influence in Hong Kong has to be through her has to be reduced, and they want democracy in their region. Then this is Giriraj's lynching solution: breed only female cows. So this is the Animal Husbandry, Dairy and Fisheries Minister Giriraj Singh in the central government. He has said that promoting artificial insemination in cattle using sex-sorted semen will help reduce lynching. He says main benefit of using this method will be that farmers can ensure that only female calves are born. So this means cows will, superior cows using insemination of cows using semen from genetically superior bulls would also improve the fertility and milk production capacity of the cows. So this will help reduce lynching, he says, because if cattle are not left to stray, then the possibility of such problems would be lowered. Then below you have government to pull out all stops to cut use of plastic. So multi-ministry effort will be launched on October 2, 2019, which includes voluntary work and awareness. So on Gandhi Jayanti, here you can see what India is going to start is ensuring and enforcing ban on single-use plastic, and also, extended producer responsibility, especially on milk packets, etc., would be finalized. It's a multi-ministry effort which would be initiated. On page 5 you have National Green Tribunal wants all states to properly deal with hazardous waste. So the panel has asked them to set up treatment and disposal facilities. So under the Central Pollution Control Board, and also on the recommendation of Central Pollution Control Board, the directions have been given by the National Green Tribunal to all states. On the editorial page, the first editorial is listen to the unspoken. So this is regarding the continuing communication restrictions in Kashmir, which have only deepened alienation in the region. So after the revoking of Article 370 of the Constitution from Jammu and Kashmir, the communication clampdown has resulted in people not having any way to speak out against or for the step being taken, and it has deepened the alienation in the region. So communication clampdown has been, restrictions have been eased now, but still the unease prevails. And this is tending to the heart. So this is regarding targeting risk factors to reduce deaths due to cardiovascular diseases is the key. So that is what has to be done. So that issue is discussed here. The Lancet published its report in which it showed how, high income countries do not have high number of deaths from cardiovascular diseases, though the risk factors there are high, but developing countries have three times more, including India, they have three times more frequent deaths due to cardiovascular diseases than due to cancer. So this issue is covered here, how we need to target risk factors to reduce deaths. The lead article is Jurisprudence of the Judicial Rubber Stamp. So this is regarding Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. Under the Act, the government has given itself powers to designate any individual as terrorists, and that has to be, that will be looked into by a tribunal. So UAPA tribunal will be established, which will be a judicial body, but will be but if it becomes a rubber stamp of the government, if it's not given independence, if it is influenced in such a manner, then fundamental principles of fair procedure will be missed. So, it says, the article says that a close reading of UAPA tribunal orders shows how fundamental principles of fair procedure are being given a miss. So, these concerns have been raised that a judicial body has been set up, but it will be just a rubber stamp. Then this is steaming back into the Indo-Pacific. So this is regarding how Indo-Pacific region is at the center stage, and Russia could be imagining a greater role for itself in reshaping the region's geopolitics. So we have already formed a four-nation quad group that has USA, Australia, Japan and India in it, and even Russia is keen to play a key role here in the Indo-Pacific region. Then on the appendix page you have, it is important to contextualize the NRC. So it says, this article says that errors aside, the process was rigorous, methodical and did not target any particular community. So that is the key to the NRC exercise. So that is emphasized here. And this is putting accident victims at the center of vehicles law. So this is regarding the new act, the Motor Vehicles Amendment Act 2019. So this act focuses more on penalties than on compensation, has been evident. We have seen how huge penalties been imposed under the new act. So this article says that there is a need to put accident victims at the center of vehicles law, that they should be paid enough compensation. Then this is India's climate score, high on vulnerability, low on resilience. So disaster management plans need to be prioritized is emphasized here, you can see. Because of climate change and worsening global warming, resulting floods, storms, heat waves and droughts have shown how India is vulnerable, highly vulnerable, and resilience is quite low. On page 13 you have, Russia opens porthole to Chennai. So this is regarding a memorandum of intent which has been signed between India and Russia for maritime communications between China and Vladivostok. And this is India-UK spar over London protests. So violent protests surrounded the Indian High Commission and broke window panes here. And this has resulted in India expressing deep concern over unruly demonstration by Pakistan-incited elements and the consequent vandalism which has taken place. Then you have, as Narmada dam fills, villages go under. So Madhya Pradesh has protested against Gujarat violating schedule ahead of rehabilitation. So this is a completely submerged Nasirpur town in Dhar district in Madhya Pradesh, because Narmada dam is full and has overflowed. Then on international page you have Hong Kong leader seeks an end to violence, promises dialogue. So government is withdrawing extradition bill, the Hong Kong government, to fully allay public concerns, says its leader Carrie Lam. So protesters, however, vowed that they would continue with the protests unless all their demands are met. So they want also the people who are arrested during these protests to be released. They should not be prosecuted. And they want more democracy in the region. Then this is British lawmakers vote on bill to block no deal Brexit. So Prime Minister Boris Johnson has demanded snap elections on October 15, but the British Parliament presently has voted to prevent Prime Minister Boris Johnson taking Britain out of EU without a deal. On business page you have external benchmark based lending must RBI. So RBI has initiated this move for faster transmission of monetary policy rates. So new norms will come into effect from October 1. These will be benchmark based lending rates. Means when the RBI reduces repo rate, the banks do not reduce their lending rates consequently. So now this external benchmark based lending has been made a must. And this is India among top 10 nations in gold reserves. So US leads the pack in the amount of gold, followed by Germany, and India is amongst the top 10 according to the World Gold Council. Then on the last page you have Vienna crowned most livable city. So this is Austria's capital Vienna, which has retained its rank as the world's most livable city according to annual report from Economist Intelligence Unit, which is a research division of the Economist Group. The Indian cities as such, Delhi has dropped 6 places in this year's ranking. Delhi, it has come down to 118th rank now. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com. Thank you.